So we're now still talking about the strategy. The strategy is first use a QR factorization to make A into, well, it's tempting to say into an upper triangular matrix because maybe we can take advantage of its upper triangular form, but actually that's not going to help us a whole lot. So the more important thing is that we now have created a square matrix that we want to compute the singular value decomposition of. Okay, so let's now go over here and simply say, okay, now A is square and we're trying to compute the singular value decomposition of a square matrix. Now what? Well, we don't want to form A Hermitian A. Okay? What we're going to see in the next unit is that you can take a matrix A and you can compute unitary matrices UA and VA such that the resulting matrix is bidiagonal. Now, what do we mean by bidiagonal? This matrix has a diagonal and one superdiagonal. Now, why is that important? Well, obviously, once we have actually reduced our matrix A to bidiagonal form, we can then compute the singular value decomposition of our matrix B, and we can then combine that with our matrices UA and VA, and we can then combine that with our matrix Q, and with all of that, if we do it just right, we end up with something like the reduced singular value decomposition of our original matrix A. Okay, now, what's next? Well, we want to compute the singular value decomposition now of matrix B. How might we do that? Well, we could form B Hermitian transpose times B. And notice that if you multiply a bidiagonal matrix from the left by its Hermitian transpose, then you get a tridiagonal matrix. Okay. Ah, and then we can use our tridiagonal QR algorithm in some form to compute the spectral decomposition of that matrix. But wait a minute. We did not want to form A Hermitian transpose times A, because that would possibly square the condition number of matrix A. We really don't want to do the same thing with matrix B. So the question now becomes, can we somehow come up with a QR-like algorithm, as a matter of fact, a QR algorithm, but for the bidiagonal matrix, where the purpose is to compute the singular value decomposition. And the key insight is that there is this relationship with a tridiagonal matrix. And the other key insight is our friend, the implicit Q theorem. And that's what we are going to exploit in the next unit.